Hi guys, welcome to episode 22 of Metal Reviewcast. Today we're reviewing InVisions' newest single called Gold Blooded. We've all seen this song already and have told InVisions how much we like the song, so we thought we'd make an episode on it.
It's fire. What else were you going to talk about, Leon, just at the start?
I was also going to talk about how Lucas from InVisions the other day did a live show on Facebook and was just playing remixes of their songs, and I thought that were like pretty cool, and he had like loads of people actually watching it.
He did just smack his mic
a little bit quieter.
Yeah, that's a dangerous game as well, isn't it, because it'll make him sound like a drunken robot when that happens. But yeah, it was really interesting to see having that, and I know some other bands have done it, but to have a band that we know and love release their stems out to the public to be able to do remixes and have a competition, and then listen to the you know, what InVisions would class as their favorite ones, it's absolutely phenomenal. I was just sat there pinned listening to the different styles. There's one from the 80s, they had some EDM, some dubstep. It was just really good, and I guess for me that just shows you know, well, as a band, you can take some time out a little bit in terms of doing touring. It's really important to kind of think about how you're going to engage your fans and also keep yourself active and keep that music flowing and promote yourself. And maybe not promote yourself as pushing your musical agenda, but just have ideas and pass things around and make a community, because effectively they're the people that are going to support you. So I thought that was really cool.
True that. Yeah, because as I mentioned, like, I saw Silverstein do it probably just a couple of weeks or a week before that as well, and they handed out the stems. And I was like, oh, it's a really good idea. I hadn't seen any other bands do it, and then InVisions come along and do it as well. So,
yeah.
Yeah, that was cool. That was cool. So, again, props to InVisions. We always keep giving them props to the way they handle their marketing, media, PR and stuff. But, you know, if you need ideas, just look at those guys. They're fucking awesome.
Lucas sits there and replies to like 200 comments each individually with his own personality, because he knows every person.
The guy's insane. He's a machine. Like, you get a reply within a fucking minute. You're just kind of like, what the hell? He's actually liked your reply before you finish replying. You know what I mean? Like, what the fuck? Sorry about the flag, guys. I was just made it. That's nothing to do with COVID. I just thought I'd wrap it around my face and look like a Caribbean ninja. Grenada. No, that's Spain. Do I look Spanish?
It's not Granada.
I do not look Spanish.
He doesn't know.
Don't listen to him. Don't listen to him. He's foolish. But yeah, this song. Oh, I think is this the first song that we put on Metal Reviewcast that Leon has actually listened to before we review it?
Yes, it is.
Feels like it.
I couldn't wait to listen to it on the show, so I just decided I'd listen to it before, and I'm glad I did.
It's not that you forgot, or you were too tired.
No.
Cool, hit that button, bro.
Hey, let's play. I like what they've done here, because they've made it so that you can't tell whether they're in a warehouse or not. They've made it all dark with like bright like lights all around.
Yeah, there's a bit of a flash, but they made it interesting. It could be a stadium, a stage or whatever.
It's a cool background though. It works.
The pace on this is brilliant.
That little high-pitched guitar then is so good.
It's just nasty. That was nice as well. Oh, I've got chills. They're fucking up the ante, mate. I'm telling you, it just gets better. Up their game.
This bit's so naughty.
As well, just going back to the actual video itself, what I like about this is it's not far off their actual shows in terms of they're like, if you go to the shows that they've got a bigger stage, they have like some lighting at the background, they have like screens and stuff, and you see like stuff like that. It's really nice.
Yeah,
they think of everything. That's so good.
I love that bit.
People are going to die in that mosh pit. They're going to actually die. There's not even limbs flying or a bit of blood. Like, people are going to fucking die. And do you know something else as well? Like, I don't know whether it's just me, and we're being honest on this show, and they can criticize me for my views, if they, you know, like, as in Leon and Sean can criticize me on my views or on this, but that to me, whilst it's ridiculously heavy, the drop is ridiculous. Everything about that song is just hard. It also sounds like, to me, anyone can listen to it. Like, it doesn't seem like it's so far fetched in the realms of screamo and other things that actually people who wouldn't normally listen to metal, for example, could easily appreciate and enjoy that song. That's how it feels to me. Like, it just was really easy listening whilst it was aggressive as fuck. Just saying, that's my opinion anyway. What's your thought?
I don't agree, but
you don't agree?
No, because I know what people are like. I know what, like, my friends are like, and even people that listen to rock, just they can't get down with even some of the melodic stuff that I listen to, so...
Maybe I'm too far invested into it.
Yeah, I do get what you mean. But, like, I go back and listen to stuff. Like, even Parasite, and it doesn't seem as heavy as it used to. But it is, especially when you hear it live. But I know what you mean. I actually mentioned this to Ben on Facebook. I posted it on him. He shared it as well. That's probably my favourite alongside Life Lost and Never Enough vocally from him.
His vocals were ridiculous.
I love his cleans in this as well. We already know how good he is at screaming. It's got a little bit of rap screaming, his forte. And then he does a bit more cleans like he does in like Life Lost and stuff. And I just love it. The variety.
I love that. Give it up. What? At the start, probably just going G.
So yeah, just the whole band are so good. I just can't criticize. I know I love them, but I just can't criticize them.
No, they need to find a way to find us something to moan about, because I actually have nothing to moan about on that at all. If anything, even more of a positive that, and bearing in mind when you listen to things on YouTube, it washes out some of the clarity and the audio, but I could literally hear absolutely everything from the guitars to the tiny minute detail of some of the cymbals, sorts of stuff. It's like, I don't know where they've recorded it, whether it's in a sound or somewhere else. It's got even better, and they've always had good recordings. And
yeah, it's in a sound, yeah.
It is.
Yeah. Well Lucas works there, doesn't he?
No. Well,
I say now. It was like, I can't remember, last year at some point, I think he...
Because I sent a message to Josh separately just saying, yo, the drums, what the fuck? They sound amazing. And he was like, yeah, you know, we've upped our game. So, and absolutely, it's, yeah, it's great. And it's lovely to hear those pre-hit ghosts on there as well. Nice. Just, oh.
They're just so good. Even like the subtle changes where there's those little, I don't know what to call them, but strange bits of guitar where it like goes real high pitched.
And you
like
know,
kind of stuff. I'm like, wow, they've like even added kind of some extra bits to their playing. It's not just all aggression. There's some difference.
Yeah, and you know what? It's something that Lucas touched on that when he was live doing listening back to the EDM stuff, where they were trying to find a way to incorporate that kind of mindset where there's little, you know, the glitches in some EDM music where you hear it and there's just little touches before it drops and stuff, and adding that, and now hearing that in the tune but actually played as a guitar, I now feel what they're like. I totally get it, and it's like you say, you just picked up on that, like that, those little subtleties that like bridge the gap between like one part of the song to another one before it drops and things like that. It's just
like another example was like at the end of the song they had like some faint synth that they didn't have at that bit in the rest of the song as well. I noticed.
They're just so good. I don't even know what to say. Apart from that, I showed Joss the other day as well that my top 10 played songs of last year were InVisions, 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 InVisions. Every song was InVisions. And then it went like, I think there was like Architects, Polaris, like for two songs. And then it was like the other InVisions album.
This is rate higher than fucking Architects and Polaris. That's some fucking shit.
But no. Hell coming out like end of the year before? I can't remember. January, I can't remember exactly, but yeah, they beat, in my mind, they beat Architects on my playlist anyway.
You might start a war here.
Yeah.
Not with me.
And we'll win it. They'll write a song for me.
Sweet. No, mate. InVisions, can't wait to see you guys. I'm gutted we didn't get to see you during this current pandemic and stuff. You know, obviously it wasn't possible, it's not viable, it's not safe to, but I can't wait till things lift up a little bit and we can see you live and just hear that and try and duck the limbs that go flying across the stage and across the mosh pit.
Boys in Isolate, obviously, on that one as well. They've released the rescheduled dates, I think.
Yeah, they have, yeah.
I haven't actually looked at them because I don't really know when we're going to be able to. I don't want to get excited.
No, exactly. It's subject to change at any point, isn't it? We can't.
Either way, we'll be there whenever.
I finished my beer.
Wow.
But I started it before we. That's not fair. I'm going to quickly get another one.
Because he's an alcoholic.
I am.
Can't go one video without more than one beer. I feel bad that I have like a coffee, sometimes two in these videos. Well, two videos.
You might like this one, Sean. This is a this is Buxton Brewery. It's a nice little can here.
Beer review cast now. Hold on.
Yeah. Buxton Brewery. We're not sponsored by these people or anything. I got them from Beer 52 and I'm not sponsored by them because they keep taking my fucking money. Right. But yeah, you like this because it's an extra porter. If you look at the label there, extra porter Costa Rican coffee.
Oh, yeah. I usually like those. I think that'd be better as well. Is that a smaller can?
Yeah. Yeah.
With my better volume because it's bigger cans. Murder.
New glass from Flavorly.
Again, not sponsored.
Not sponsored at all.
It's not an alcoholic.
And that's fine, but.
Thursday is the new Friday because we're recording this on Thursday because Friday is a bank holiday due to VE Day. But yeah, this is the new Friday.
Beers.
Yeah.
Beers.
It helps me grow my hair. Anyway, so swiftly moving on whilst I pour this beer.
Swiftly. So,
well.
Just waffled for like 5 minutes.
It was good waffle. We were talking about beers and how epic. No, fuck you. He started this, right? How epic that band was. We're a review. I was giving my points about the fucking band. Anyway.
Boomers.
We're not on the boomers. Yeah, we are on the boomers.
Here we are.
Set me up.
New format. Boomer.
Right. So, as we were touching on a few weeks back, well, in all of our stuff, we were on about supporting local bands and making sure that you go to gigs to find new bands, as well as the bands that you want to see. Myself and Sean and Leon were at a gig, I believe, forgotten which one, it was the City of Ours gig, I think. And at the beginning of that, they had a band on called Lastelle. Fucking phenomenal live. Now, all their songs are really epic and they're all quite long, so I'm just going to get to it. But this is Lastelle, The Cage I Built Myself. If you hit play, Leo.
Hit play.
It's not a warehouse.
No, it's good. The InVisions one is definitely not a warehouse as well, so that's two without a warehouse.
Good.
Well, this is thick and muddy. Oh, it's an old period property.
Yeah,
it's
isn't
like
it?
A stately home or something like that.
Yeah, a stately home with those hallways. It's like a castle.
Whoa, that's nice. Look at that.
We review music, not beer.
I love the fact that the singer is the drummer. And he's got a really nice voice.
Hey, it does.
Now, these guys, I have got a criticism for them. As much as I love them, I've got them on my playlist in my car. They don't release enough content. They're worse than we are.
We just took a 5-month break.
Yeah, like, that tells like you literally, this song's about a year ago. The latest release is 6 months ago, and the release before that was 10 months ago, and before that there was like a year apart. They like released maybe two songs in an entire year, which is a shame for me because I think they're passionate about their music and they sound great. The only other criticism I have as well, and you're probably already gonna pick up on this, Sean, the audio quality.
Yeah, I was literally about to say this. When we heard them live, we were like, "Raw, what the fuck is this?" Because, like, I still get the same sort of vibes, but it just, I don't know, it doesn't do them justice. Like, it's not as good as, well, if in a sound audio recorded, we'd never be having this conversation because we know. Live, it was like this big epic performance.
Listen to his range. Oh yeah, no, absolutely. I mean, we were all stood there like,
who the fuck is this?
Yeah, my arms, what the fuck? It was like we came down from being outside and just stopped and were like but it is definitely the studio or whoever's mastering it, because, and I intentionally didn't put it on this as my my boomer because it's 8 minutes long, it's just far too long for this video. But they've got a live version of the song that we like the most. I think it's The Silence Hurts the Most. So there's basically a live video and they're playing in the studio live, and the sound quality from that live recording is better than this. So
I wonder if this is the same place that Avara did that first song that we listened to.
And he's this screamer is interesting because it's a different type of scream, and I'm not sure what to think of it, but I like it. It works with the music.
Yeah, I agree with that. Yeah, I know what you mean.
He's like, a bit more like, it's like he's tight.
Yeah,
like he can't quite.
Like, it could be a stylistic choice because, as you said, it works really well.
Yeah.
Because it's not like we're saying it's bad. It's just different, really.
Yeah, it sounds like he's got a lump in his throat when he's screaming. And like you say, it could be a choice. And at first I was like, it sounds like he's just not breathing enough. But he clearly is. It actually just works with music. So it's probably a choice. And it sounds like I'm being really critical. And I am kind of, but not the things that I think, you know, the screaming's fine. It's just something I picked up on. I genuinely think the only thing that lets this band down is the quality of the recording. And if it was just this video, I wouldn't pick on it too much. But I've got three of their songs on my playlist on Amazon Music, and all of them are really quite poor quality.
I think it's hard, isn't it? Because like, we don't want to seem like we criticize other studio, like audio studios, or if they do it themselves, because I know some bands have done that. But Inner Sound Audio is just so good that they kind of ruin it for everyone.
But the other people have to up their game. It's the same amount of work. It's the same people. They've got to up their game. And it's not the band's fault.
No.
You know, unless obviously it's a member of the band that's mastering it. But honestly, if it is a member of the band that's mastering it, then, you know, we need to either find somebody to master it for you that's better at doing it, or you need to up your skill, because your music's fucking solid. And I put you on my boomer because I think you're fucking mint. But I'm a little let down by the audio quality.
Which, again, if that's our only criticism of a band song.
Yeah. Like, I mean, they got here for a reason, right?
Yeah, you're doing a good fucking like job.
Criticism of the band itself.
No, exactly. Not at all. Not at all.
I streamed that as well. I didn't notice that.
Yeah, and they only seem to release on Dreambound as well. They don't release via their own channels, which I get, because obviously Dreambound will give them quite a bit of promotion, but it kind of skews your actual real fan base. Like, I think if you notice that we've done reviews of multiple bands, and they'll release one on Dreambound and they'll release one on their own, and you see the disparity between the two. And I think it's important for bands to release on their own channels or other methods, just to see what that is, and to get insight from other, like their actual true fans, as well as the fans that are coming in from Dreambound. Absolutely, release on Dreambound, because obviously you need to promote yourself. But I think it's important to get true representation of what you're, you know, how big you are.
They're from Oxford as well.
Are they? So they travel all the way to Key Club for that gig. That was fucking, honestly, guys, like, you literally blew my mind when I was at that gig. And yeah, well done. And again, it goes back to local band support, or just UK band support, everything else. Support your bands.
True that. I'd actually forgotten about them, so I'm glad you brought them back up.
So I think it's time for the next boomer.
Before I start talking more, go on, do it.
Which is my one. It's a song by We Came As Romans, but it's like part of like this thing that metal bands do called Punk Goes Pop, where they do like covers of pop songs, but make it like really metal-y. And this one's like a cover of Glad You Came, which is actually a song I listened to as a kid. So it's like really good. So I'm gonna hit play. Have you heard this, Dad?
I can't remember.
I'm glad you came.
I've heard the original.
Yeah.
I think you have played a bit of it to me. That's really nice beer. I like what they've done to it.
Yeah.
I kind of... There's a bit too... For me, there's a bit too much going on with the synth as well.
I like it.
It's... That's funny. I'm glad you
came. I love this bit.
I felt that was a really good scream I did then. Right from my belly, that one. I'm just picturing the guy saying this to the girl, like, in that with that voice. I'll take you by the hand! No one can ever see!
I really like this song.
It's good, it's creative. I think, and it's nice to get see bands using their talent to do something a bit different to what is their norm.
Yeah.
Or turning something into their norm that wasn't their norm. It's good. I think it shows the capability of musicians. It's great.
Yeah, I love this punk goes pop stuff. It's so good.
Good choice, Leon.
We Came as Romans are awesome.
Good choice.
Mm-hmm.
Notice a lot of the bands in that as well. They do tend to use quite like a lot of synthy stuff. So obviously, as you said, I think they adapt. I know a lot of the bands use it anyway, but like We Came as Romans done it. There's like Elisana and stuff as well that did some, and Brief Carolina, who do quite a bit, Mayday Parade and stuff like that. Even Silverstein have done them, but a lot of the bands seem to use a bit of synth and stuff to kind of, balance it out a little bit more. So it's not
because
completely
obviously they're like pop songs, so they don't have real instruments in, so they've got to like still get that sound in somehow. So it's like they use synth for it, which then managed to make sound good.
Mm.
Some of them do aggressive ones, like August Burns Red, I think. They did one, and it's just full on aggression. I think they did Toxic by Britney Spears, if I remember.
I think they did.
I love that one. But yeah, I love Punk Goes Pop. It's just a different element, isn't it? It's nice.
Yeah.
Proper nice. My Boomer of the Week is Stepson Run. I don't know anything about them.
Ah, I've not even heard of these.
So there you go. Yeah.
Okay, you just hit me in the face, like, on the side.
Again, it was just YouTube randomly showing me things. So.
Oh, I'm intrigued. I'm intrigued.
It's about as far as my knowledge goes, because I don't know anything.
Now, are they in a warehouse?
Let's see.
No.
Not yet.
It's some digital graphical car. Okay, already a good start.
No warehouse.
Cun. Oh, run. Old American slide guitar style there.
Okay, no, it's a back alley, not a warehouse.
Isn't it? Change up.
Yeah.
I've not seen a back alley for a while, though, to be fair, so I welcome it.
Yeah.
Checking to see if you've got a chunky butt.
This is interesting.
It is.
Very different.
Yeah, that's what I quite liked about it. I was like, it's got a few different vibes.
there's like almost a ska vibe to that bit.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
I like those cleans.
That reminds me of Amity.
Yeah, a bit.
But slow.
Yeah.
I think it's his note choices.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's really good screaming. Chunky but. Oh,
it's got a really nice scream, isn't it? Because it's like, it's not like deep, dark growl.
It's very purposeful.
Yeah, but it's still got the emotion and the aggression of it.
I really like the effort gone into the video.
Is he going to go? Yeah, he's going to go fuck that guy up, isn't he? For like grabbing a woman's butt whilst he's phoning his own missus. I'm just watching the story.
Yeah. I love when music videos like tell a story.
Yeah. Have you done any research on them? Where they're from?
This is potentially another Australian band, but let me confirm that because I can't remember.
Do Australia drive on the left side of the road like us?
I think so. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I reckon it might be then.
Brisbane, Australia.
Yeah, Brisbane. Yeah.
That's another Australian band, incredible. Yeah. Like, randomly, so that's how I found them. I'm guessing they came across from Thornhill and Polaris
and the Amity Affliction.
Oh yeah.
Now I mention it, they do look Australian.
I like the pace. They do look Australian a bit, but. Look, yeah, he's fucking him up, like, grab that bitch's butt, flush your head down the toilet, phoning your wife. That's exactly what they were saying there.
I think so. Yeah, another random one that came across there.
Mate, that was a banger.
So that came out. They're part of Sharp Tone Records, apparently. It's only got 11,500 views.
Well, got a few more now, haven't they? Because we've just watched them. And hopefully, anybody who's watching this video are going to check them out as well, properly, because I talked through that. we all did, but I did, definitely. But no, that's a banger, absolute banger.
Good job, well Australia. Impressed with
that. What was that, sorry, Sean?
Good job, Australia.
Yeah.
Another one.
I'm just noticing how white my teeth look on this webcam.
They do look ultra white, yeah.
So do yours, Sean.
Why don't yours?
I don't know. Mine are naturally yellow, you know this.
They just came out yellow.
Let's see. I'm not
he's black and yellow, Sean. He's the cross between me and you.
True that. True that. But yeah.
Well impressed.
Yeah.
Well impressed. Good selection of music tonight, boys. Mm-hmm. So we had an absolute banger in InVisions. Then we had Lastelle and
good variety.
We came from Romans and Stepson.
Yeah,
we
got some variety.
Yeah, good. Rated. Oh, guys,
yeah.
Check them out in the description. Support the bands. Subscribe to us if you want to. We'd like it very much. Good. We're trying to release more content, as you've probably seen. We have a lot to deliver at the moment, which is great because that means there's lots of music. And we're trying to catch up on our back catalogue of music that we haven't reviewed thus far. So
plus finding more, plus buying some messages 3 months late.
We'll get onto those boys who have messaged us. We will get onto them. Yeah, we have a method. So we're going to be doing those as well. So respect.
So if you don't message you straight away, don't worry, we will.
Cool. Right. Yeah. Peace. I'm done.
Goodbye.
Peace. Ciao.